Hey everybody, it's Coach Bill here with a tip of the week, and this week's tip is about pebble questions. Thanks very much for joining me. So let's talk about pebble questions. I thought what I could share with you is, number one, the origin and the genesis of the term and the concept, number one, number two, their value in selling and where we should use them in the Crestone sales process, and then number three, some of the types of questions that you can start to shape and ask to drive a great dialogue, and hopefully at the end of stage three meetings, get an agreement for statements to build a proposal. So let's talk about the genesis of pebble questions. You know, the nature of the pebble is, hey, listen, you can walk a mile with a pebble in your shoe, or you can tolerate that, right? It's not going to stop your journey per se, but it is an annoyance or a tolerance or some constructive discontent. So I'd like to acknowledge that, as opposed to tell me about all your problems and where the sky is falling and what you're not getting and what your needs are. Folks don't want to talk about that. Successful people want to build upon their success, right? They're very positive thinkers, and they have a pretty strong base of thinking and feeling and confidence. So we want to build upon that. And I always find I get more out of a dialogue when I acknowledge what's working, or I acknowledge success that you want to build upon, or kind of close that gap between where you are and where you're going. So that's the nature of pebble questions. It also comes from 20 years of research and coaching and working with the C-suite and senior executives and high net worth individuals, where they really don't want to educate salespeople. There's kind of this unwritten feeling or this expectation that we should do our homework and we should know a little bit about them before we ask, you know, these extemporaneous or perfunctory questions before we get into a dialogue. So that's part of the genesis. So number two, when do we use the, or part two, when do we use the pebble questions in the dialogue? Particularly, I'm thinking stage three conversations where we're getting a little deeper, we're trying to test assumptions and explore needs more deeply so that we can best position Crestone's capability uniquely in terms of what an individual or a family particularly might need. So the pebble question really serves us there, and it helps us do a little bit of investigating whether or not this is a competitive situation, whether or not they have some discontent with their current provider, whether or not they've thought hard, if they've got a clear path in terms of what's next for them 6 months from now, a year from now, or 5 years from now. It blows my mind in terms of, you know, around who people really, you know, have not thought that out. And on the other spectrum, it's amazing how people have a journey scoped out for the next 30 years. So whatever that is, we want to tap into that so that we can best position Crestone's capability. And I think the pebble questions for us need to focus around service levels. That positions us to talk about our level of service and high touch. We can talk about a dimension of service that they have an expectation around, and you know, where would they say might be a gap or two related to the service they're currently providing, and if they had to switch firms or think differently now given their liquidity event and what opportunities lie ahead for them, what that service should look like and feel like, as a kind of a gateway for you to explain the service model at Crestone. So that's a great pebble question. The other pebble question I have is, you know, who, for big decisions, you know, in your world, who's your thinking partner? You know, before you make a big purchase, make a big hire, think about a business partner, all those big decisions you made over the last 5 to 10 to 15 years, who do you like to consult with? Or maybe what's your kind of thought pattern or buying process, if you will, as you engage something like that or make a big decision? Many of our clients say that we're their thinking partner, and they like operating with us because they help us with decisions, both financial and non. So that's a great way to use a pebble question in an innocent, positive way to get some information. So that's really powerful. And the third thing is around pebble questions is, this is important in stage three meetings when, you know, we're all taking notes and you have a subject matter expert with you or several, is that we can kind of compare notes and we can all ask our questions related to our discipline. So want to be mindful of preparing those questions in advance based on either planning or tax consequences. So those are my thoughts around pebble questions. And the offer is, if you've got a meeting coming up, feel free to send me 2 to 3 to 4 of the pebble questions that you'd like to ask. Even if it's in fuzzy areas that you really haven't focused on yet, or you don't have yet the words, let me help you script that. We'll help you get ready for your next meeting. So this is Coach Bill. Thanks so much. Tip of the week. And the topic is pebble questions. Good selling, everybody.